Welcome to your daily devotional reading from the book My Life Today, Month of November, A Victorious Life. November 25th, with Liberality. There is that scattereth and yet increaseth, and there is that withholdeth more than is meet, but it tendeth to poverty. The liberal soul shall be made fat, and he that watereth shall be watered also himself. Proverbs 11, verses 24 and 25. It is God who blesses men with property, and he does this that they may be able to give toward the advancement of his cause. He sends the sunshine and the rain. He causes vegetation to flourish. He gives health and the ability to acquire means. All our blessings come from his bountiful hand. In turn, he would have men and women show their gratitude by returning him a portion in tithe and offerings, in thank offerings, in freewill offerings, in trespass offerings. Should means flow into the treasury in accordance with this divinely appointed plan, a tenth of all the increase and liberal offerings, there would be an abundance for the advancement of the Lord's work. But the heart of men become hardened through selfishness, and like Ananias and Sapphira, they are tempted to withhold part of the price while pretending to fulfill God's requirements. Many spend money lavishly in self-gratification. Men and women consult their pleasure and gratify their taste while they bring to God, almost unwittingly, a stinted offering. They forget that God will one day demand a strict account of how his goods have been used. Constant self-denying benevolence is God's remedy for the cankering sins of selfishness and covetousness. God has arranged systematic benevolence to sustain his cause and relieve the necessities of the suffering and needy. He has ordained that giving should become a habit, that it may counteract the dangerous and deceitful sin of covetousness. Continual giving stabs covetousness to death. He requires the constant exercise of benevolence, that the force of habit in good works may break the force of habit in opposite direction. Continual giving stabs covetousness to death. He requires the constant exercise of benevolence, that the force of habit in good works may break the force of habit in an opposite direction. A Victorious Life, November 25th.